Chengdu, one of China's biggest cities, is going into lockdown for a citywide mass testing. All its 21 million residents are ordered to stay home beginning Thursday. Only one person per household is allowed to go out to shop for necessities. Chengdu is the largest city to be locked down since Shanghai was shut for 2 months earlier this year. It's unclear if the lockdown in Chengdu will be lifted after the four-day mass testing ends on Sunday. The new and updated COVID booster shots of rivals Moderna and Pfizer-BioNTech get the green light from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Moderna's vaccine is authorized for use as a single booster dose in adults, while Pfizer-BioNTech's shot is approved for individuals 12 years old and above. Both of the company's updated boosters target the BA4 and BA5 lineages of the Omicron variant, which account for around 90% of all new cases in the U.S. The booster shots, though, will still need to get a thumbs up from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention before vaccinations begin. Former Malaysian Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad hospitalized for COVID-19. According to his office, the 97-year-old was admitted Wednesday morning for observation. Mahathir, who has had heart problems over the years, has been actively touring the country in recent weeks to beef up support for his new political party. That's amid speculation that snap polls could be held before the end of the year. The veteran politician has served twice as Malaysia's prime minister, first in 1981 to 2003, then in 2018. But his administration collapsed in 2020 due to infighting. Here at home, Cebu City implements its relaxed mask rule despite pushback from the Health and Interior Departments. It was DILG Secretary Benher Abalos who said Cebu City Mayor Michael Rama had agreed to defer enforcing the policy. But locals in Cebu City were able to go out without face masks Thursday, and they were not apprehended. Mayor Rama confirmed meeting with Abalos, but he asserts they will continue to promote the use of face masks through self-regulation.
Importante ngayon, nire-review ko yung executive order ko. Wala naman ako dapat actually ililip. Wala naman akong sinasabing huwag na kayong mag-wear ng face mask. Ginagawa ko non-obligatory lang.
Rama also saying it's about time for government's COVID task force to recalibrate its pandemic policies.
Ayoko lang yung statement ng DOH na sinasabi ng DOH na kukonsultahin pa namin sila. Ayoko yun. Kasi sa local government code po, kaya naman doon. Sila yung kukonsult sa amin. Kami yung ini-elect. Kami yung nandun sa baba. Alam namin yung nangyayari sa baba. Dapat nirespeto rin yung sitwasyon na yan. I wish yung IETF, kung nandyan pa sila, they should be more circumspect kasi iba-iba itong peculiarities natin all over the country.
As it stands, Cebu City only requires the wearing of face masks in hospitals and other medical facilities. Meanwhile, the mask mandate stays nationwide. The health department's officer in charge, Maria Rosario Verjeri, says the agency respects the autonomy of local governments. But she points out the law states under a public health emergency, local leaders should follow protocols issued by the national government. Verjeri asserts vaccination coverage and the healthcare system must first be improved before the mask mandate can be eased.
The Department of Health positions that the mask is still very much protective of our population, that the mask mandate should continue on until we can be able to improve our vaccination coverage and therefore have that kind of safeguard. That's where the problem lies, because everybody of us, local governments, national government, should always prioritize public health. There would always be this autonomy for local governments, but in this time of the pandemic, we should act as one nation. We cannot be implementing different policies because, as I've said, this virus crosses borders.